Thanks for watching. We appreciate you. Please, please subscribe.
Nick has been shut down after a young woman in their care was found dead. Good evening. This is the KTLA 5 News at 5:30. I'm Cher Calvin.
And I'm Pedro Rivera. Family members are now suing, claiming the clinic had not been following proper protocols. And if they were, the 24-year-old woman will still be alive today.
KTLA Shelby Nelson spoke with family members and joins us live with more in Riverside. Shelby.
Yeah, Cher, Pedro, that family has spent several months agonizing over the death of 24-year-old Melissa Bowman, and now they're taking legal action.
She was like the life of the party, goofy, just a great, great person with a heart of gold.
Loving, passionate, and caring, just some of the qualities mom Carrie Ryder remembers about her 24-year-old daughter and middle child Melissa Bowman.
Melissa, not like my other daughters, is very dependent on me. She was still like my baby.
Melissa had struggled with addiction for a while and more recently was introduced to fentanyl, but she didn't want to be defined by her addiction, later telling her mom she was ready to get clean. That's when Carrie picked her daughter up and took her to the Arlington Recovery Community and Sobering Center in Riverside, a center providing treatment for community members battling mental illness and substance abuse. It was Saturday, July 23rd, but by Tuesday, Carrie received the worst news she could get. Her daughter was found dead at the same facility.
I thought 100% that was the absolute safest place for her to be, and it ended up not being safe at all.
Investigators with Riverside Police say that the county coroner determined that Melissa's cause of death was due to an accidental overdose on fentanyl. The family and their lawyer now filing a civil lawsuit against Riverside County and MFI Recovery, the company the county contracted out to run the center, also known as the ARC. Among the allegations, the family's attorney says MFI staff created fabricated logs to show they were checking on Melissa every 30 minutes.
MFI's sole job is to make sure that Melissa's okay while she's getting sober. I could see that they were modified after Melissa's death, and I could see that multiple instances where they're claiming to have gone and checked on Melissa just hours before her death were lies. They didn't go.
Months after Melissa's death on December 8th, Riverside County terminated its contract with MFI Recovery. A county spokesperson says that a licensure check by the state's Department of Health Care Services resulted in the ARC residential facility and MFI Recovery being cited for deficiencies. Their provisional license was also revoked. It's still unclear if Melissa's death is what led to the center's closure, but her mother will keep fighting. And we did reach out to MFI Recovery for comment. They have not yet responded, but Riverside Police tell us just last month there was another death at the Sobering Center, the building right behind me, which is adjacent to the ARC where Melissa's body was found. At the time, MFI was not running either of those facilities. It was under another service provider. Riverside Police tell us that they are investigating and are waiting for a cause of death from the coroner. Reporting live in Riverside, I'm Shelby Nelson, KTLA 5 News.
Thanks for watching. We appreciate you. Please, please subscribe.